Good morning, boys and girls.
Good morning, Missy!
Today we are learning a new name of God. It is Emmanuel. Emmanuel means God with us. When God sent Jesus to the earth, he was with us. Jesus came to show us what God is like. He came to show us love and wants to be with us forever. Today, my class is going to present to you a chapel based on a book. The book has you open one box each day for 7 days, but of course, we're going to be opening all the boxes today. I want you to pay very, very close attention to box number 7. It is very important, and some of your teachers might ask you some questions about it when you get back to class. So pay close attention. So Casey presents what God wants for Christmas. Box number 1. The angel Gabriel. In the beginning, God started to plan to bring about Christmas. It would be grand. Here he would launch a gift-giving tradition. I'll tell you how it started, so please pay attention. But before we get to the story's heart, let me explain how I play a part, the angel Gabriel. I was involved a long time ago. As an angel and speaker, it's God's word I know. For I stand in his presence, I'm Gabriel. And God wants you to hear the story I tell. For my words will offer his great gift to you, and you'll know what he wants when the story is through. What's God want for Christmas, you might say? It's to you a surprise. In box number 7, it is disguised, but no peeking. Be patient, for you must wait. It's what you offer him. It's really great. Box number 2. Mary. The story began when Isaiah did tell that a virgin would give birth to Emmanuel. That name is special. It means God with us. And one day in this child we would trust. So when the time came, I was appointed to tell the young woman that she was anointed. I said to her, Mary, you're God's chosen one, and you will give birth to God's son. How can this be? For this isn't typical. Indeed, it's not. We call it a miracle. God's Holy Spirit will help you give birth to God in the flesh. He'll live here on earth. God says to name this baby boy Jesus. Mary said, yes. May God do as he pleases, for I am his servant and I will obey, so God can use me in this very special way. What God wants for Christmas? It's to you a surprise. In box number 7, it is disguised, but no peeking. Be patient, for this you must wait. It's what you offer him. That's really, really great. Box number 3. Joseph. Sweet Mary now knew she'd be Jesus' mother. But moms need some help, don't they? She needed another. And Jesus would soon need a here on earth dad. God knew all that. Here's the plan he had. God had a man named Joseph in mind. He'd make a good husband who's loving and kind. So one night, God sent an angel to speak instructions to Joseph while he lay asleep. Joseph, take Mary. She'll be a good wife. This marriage is still God's plan for your life. God's Spirit has given her a baby within. His name will be Jesus. He'll save you from your sin. What God wants for Christmas, you might ask? It's to you a surprise. In box number 7, it is disguised. But no peeking. Be patient. For this you must wait. It's what you offer him, and it's really great. I wonder what's in the next box. What do you think?
Four.
Oh, box number 4. Okay, let's see. Box number 4. baby Jesus. After a while, there came a decree, go back to where you're from originally. So this couple set out to Bethlehem town, and when they arrived, they looked all around. But the inns were too full, no room for two guests, and Mary was tired. She needed to rest. No rooms are empty, the innkeeper said, but then he had an idea pop in his head. My stable's not much, but there you can stay. I'll give you this manger, a feed trough with hay. Later on, there in the quiet of the night, to Joseph and Mary's excited delight, she gave birth to God's son. But it was not a surprise. God said it would happen, and God never lies. God gave the first gift that first Christmas day. He gave us the Christ, the babe in the hay. But that is not all. God wants something grand, an offering to him to point to his plan. What God wants for Christmas, you might ask? It's to you a surprise. In box number 7, it is disguised. But no peeking. Be patient, for this you must wait. It's what you offer him. It's really great. We're almost there, guys. Box number 5. Shepherds. During the night when all was still quiet, shepherds were sheep watching out on a hill. A savior is born, boomed a rushing wind voice. I heard Messiah, it's time to rejoice. Now what stood before them, an angel in white, with eyes full of fire and stature and might? Go to Bethlehem now, in a stable you'll find a babe in a manger, that is your sign. Then finding a stable where they saw a light shine through the wall boards and into the night. The shepherds looked in, and what did they see? The manger, a baby, they fell to their knees. So this must be him, this is the sign. They had found Jesus, the Savior divine. These shepherds joined in the first celebration of Christmas because of this grand revelation. What does God want for Christmas? It's to you a surprise. In box number 7, it is disguised. But no peeking, be patient, for this you must wait. It's what you offer him. That's really great. Box number 6. Wise men. Now, way in the east lived some men who were wise. They saw a new star when they looked to the skies. This must be the star written in our book. It'll tell of a king. Let's go take a look. So they followed the star till it finally rested where Mary the mother and Jesus nested. When they stepped inside, they fell to the floor to worship the king, but then there was more. These men gave him frankincense, myrrh, and fine gold to honor the one the new star had foretold. Then, in a dream, they learned not to go back. By way of King Herod, he planned to attack. So they chose to go home a different way. The child's location they did not portray. As Mary thought through these events in her mind, she said, God is so loving, protective, and kind. But what does God want for Christmas? To you, it's a surprise. In box number 7, it is disguised, but no peeking. Be patient, for this you must wait. It's what you offer him, and it's really great. It seems like we have all the pieces of our manger here. I wonder what box number 7 is. Let's see. Box number 7. What God wants for Christmas. For Christmas, now here's the surprise in box number 7, where it's been disguised. Peeking in the box for so long you have waited, what God wants is you, the one he created. Me, you ask? Why is this so? I cannot wrap me and put a bow. No, you cannot. But what you can give are the choices you make in life that you live. God wants you to know him and love him within, and this is called worship, an offering to him. To do this, trust Jesus who died in your place when you didn't deserve him. This is called grace. Pray now and offer your life and your heart to God. Say, Jesus, I need you. I'd like a new start. Forgive me today for the sins I've committed, so one day in heaven, I will be permitted. When you make this decision to accept Christ, the heavens rejoice that you have made worship of God's life your choice. God wants you to know him, so choose every day to love God and thank God and give him all your praise. And boys and girls, if you want to accept Jesus, if you want to know more about accepting Jesus, you can talk to one of your teachers or any of the staff here, and we would love to tell you about how Jesus' love can save you. For being a great audience, let's fold our hands and let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we thank you for this day. We thank you we can come to chapel and worship you, Lord. And Lord, throughout this season, please let these boys and girls know that it's all about you, Jesus, that you came to this earth to save them, Lord, and let each of them learn to love, know, and serve you all the days of their life. Bless the rest of our day in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Ready?
Merry Christmas!
Keep your eyes on your teacher, please, boys and girls.